during the Mantle of Deborah Apostolic and Prophetic Women Conference at Kololo Airstrip, the First Lady of Uganda, Janet Kataha Museveni, attended via Zoom.
Extend a warm welcome to my daughter and friend, Apostle Isi, who birthed this ministry and the People of Influence Network with a formidable vision to raise an apostolic generation of women that are awakened to purpose, influencing the systems of the world power of knowledge and insights from the kingdom of God.
In her speech, the First Lady highlighted the three formidable roles of Deborah, describing Deborah as a great woman.
Reserved today for the heads of states of nations. Furthermore, Deborah is the only woman in the Bible who had the great privilege of mirroring the Lord as the judge, as a lawgiver, and king, as described in Isaiah 33, verse 22.
The Undersecretary of the First Lady's Office, Irene Kauma, highlighted the significance of the event in bolstering women's self-confidence.
What happened here? It's just a clarion call to the women to rise up to their places of calling, to rise up and embrace destiny, and to do this not in competition with men. This is not a feminist movement. This is not to say we are women, we don't need men. We actually need them. Deborah did not arise alone. Deborah worked with in partnership with Barak. Deborah was the life of Lapidoth. So for us, we are not calling women to stand and say, we don't need women. I mean men, we can stand on our own. We are saying women.
Apostle Isi Inegba, representing the Mount of Deborah office in Nigeria, led the assembly in prayer, invoking strength and guidance.
See, but not many see. The few that can see and understand that it's not a woman in a yellow cloth that is standing in front of you, but it's an entire portfolio of heaven and an intention of God for a generation. If you can see it, then you can have it.
Eva Masiko unveiled plans for the upcoming House of Prayer Africa at the Botanical Gardens, emphasizing their dedication to catalyzing positive change across the continent by empowering women in their professions.
Our fathers who started this in the 1990s used to mostly pray, but God told them that prayer by itself is not enough, that we need to develop Christians, we need to grow their skills, they need to learn how to do business as well, they need to be excellent professionals. So Africa House of Prayer is a platform which gathers us together, both to pray but also learn how to be effective professionals.
Monica Mwonge expressed gratitude to all attendees and encouraged them to participate in the forthcoming House of Prayer Africa conference, fostering a spirit of collaboration and empowerment among women. Report compiled by Sharon Nabasirie for the news.